Though brilliant, Reuben was quite insane. A compromise of ethics on our part. He seemed motivated, obsessed with revenge against something never specified. We discovered what he was doing in secret. Torturing. A penchant for traps. A serial killer masquerading around as a scientist.
Pathways are shut down until system is rebooted. Thank you for waiting.
His demeanor has turned far too aggressive and his techniques even more perverse. Da Vinci would dissect corpses to further his anatomical studies, but what Reuben has done goes beyond demanding his subjects be aware as he dissects them to truly see how the mind reacts. He's more of a butcher than an artist. But we must remain scientists above all. I had taught him from a young age that the end shall justify the means, but I could not have predicted things to be this extreme. Mobius has learned of his involvement due to my carelessness. I've asked they bring him on board to assist in development. Perhaps offering him better facilities and support will refocus him and stave off his gruesome proclivities.
This machine was designed for me. People like you, you took my life away, turned me into an abomination. Finally, with this machine, I can go back. I can live the life I was supposed to have.
We are forgiving. We are willing to overlook your certain peculiarities for what you can provide us. But you are testing our limits, our manpower. Our resources are not here for your pathetic fantasy. You will reverse the calibration on the machine so we can use it without you.
And what if I say no? You think Jimenez can fix this? You need me, and there's no way around it.
Ruvik. No. Reuben. This was where he was doing his research with us. We were just using him. And I doubt he's the first.
Thank you.
over here. Hey! Back.
Please enjoy this music while waiting.
You've got to be kidding me. I'm all right for now. What the?
Thank you.
me.
Keep your emotions out of this, Jimenez. He brought this upon himself. We gave him a chance.
Where is he?
If you really wish to know, he's in the next room. Come, see.
What is this monstrosity?
Despicable? Coming from the man using his own patience to further his own research? The irony of this situation is amusing. But even you must realize what we can do with this.
This means STEM will run. We can continue the experiments.
And your assistance is even more necessary than before.
This whole project... From the beginning, it was about deceit.
Thank you. they have done to him, and I am appalled. To think the young boy I mentored is now this, a mass of gray matter in a glorified test tube. Could they have been planning this all along? And what have I become in all of this? They've managed to keep his mind alive by simulating an artificial body. His consciousness is being confined to a mental straitjacket, a gear in their infernal machine. They have even stricken his name in humanity, referring to him by an anagram, Ruvik. A crude joke, as if spitting on his grave. I almost felt the urge to smash the case and end it right there. But my anger was quickly replaced by scientific curiosity. Reuben's legacy will live on. I will spearhead the next step. I will create something of my own out of this tragedy.
What you see here is one of the first STEM prototypes. It requires a physical connection from user to host. But Beacon houses a newer version with a wireless transmitter. All the user hears is a high-pitched tone, and they're connected. We've gotten word Jimenez is prepping for unauthorized usage. We would like the trial run to be on our terms, not his.
Have been when Jimenez activated it. The stem and beacon. That's where it all started. There must be a way to get out of this world from there.
For you, kid. You're asking too many questions, ignoring your mission. Running from responsibility. Just like you always do.
No, that's not true! You don't know me!
That much is obvious. But we need to make sure you do what you're told.
You're lying to me. Hiding things. I can't trust you! Not like this!
You are not required to trust us. Only to obey.